This is a story very close to my heart. The story of a village that gave me refuge after a snowstorm. The story of a family that took me in and made me one of their own. The story of a culture changing rapidly with time while also staying true to its roots. The story of one of the most beautiful and harshest places in the world. This is the story of Todnam, the little village with a big heart. Todnam is a small village of about 10 households located in the Pin Valley region of Spiti. It is a typical Spiti village with whitewashed houses clustered together in the middle of pea and barley fields. It is a pretty village surrounded by impressive looking mountains on all sides. If Todnam is pretty in the summers, it looks absolutely spectacular during the winter months, especially under a fresh coat of snow. It is in this setting that I first came across Todnam in the spring of 2017. It was April and I was hiking between the villages of Pin Valley when I was caught in a snowstorm and spent 2 days stuck in a tent with non-stop snowfall and heavy winds howling outside. My tiny bivy tent was buried by the snow and I was pinned down in that cramped space, unable to move, cook, or even melt snow for water during those 2 days. I abandoned my camp as soon as the snowfall stopped and went wading through the ocean of snow looking for refuge in the nearest village. That nearest village turned out to be Todnam. The villagers saw me coming from far away and understood my situation. Instead of waiting around for me to reach the village, they came out a couple of kilometers in the deep snow to welcome me with warm smiles and a flask of hot tea. They took me to Nawang Tanzin's house, where everyone in the village had gathered for a ceremony, and his family welcomed me with open arms. This is how I first stumbled upon Todnam and began a love affair with the village that would continue for the next couple of years and counting. I stayed with Nawang's family for about a week until the snow melted just enough for me to dig out my tent and get moving again. And over the course of that week, I became close to his family, which comprised of Nawang, his wife Chunit, and their two sons, Seringpunchok and Kunsang Sharab. Living with them was their great-grandmother Evie, who at 93 is the oldest person in Pin Valley. The family was going through some tough times of their own, but they were exceedingly kind to me and made me feel right at home. I got especially close to their youngest son Seringpunchok, who is quite the character and took it upon himself to become my guide and introduce me to various aspects of life in his village and in Pin Valley in general. We will be seeing a lot more of Sering as the series unfolds. Todnam is primarily a farming village. The pea crop is the main and sometimes only source of income for its people, and they make a decent living through it. It snows very heavily in Pin Valley during the winters, and that leads to a lot of grass growing in the mountains during the summer months. The villagers take advantage of all this grass by raising the chamurthi horses. These highly prized horses are a specialty of Pin Valley, and the trading of these animals is a traditional source of income for the people. Every household would have a few Chamurthi horses in addition to other livestock like yaks, donkeys and cows. Life is busy in the village all through the year. The people toil hard in their fields during the spring and summer months in order to ensure a good harvest. Autumn is spent preparing for the upcoming winter by stocking up on supplies like grass for their animals and dry dung for cooking and heating their homes during the cold winter months. The winters are harsh with heavy winds, heavy snowfall, and the temperatures plunging to minus 20 degrees centigrade. Heavy snowfall sometimes blocks the road for weeks at a time and cuts off Pin Valley from the outside world. The people and their animals spend most of their time indoors during the winter months. The villagers take advantage of all this free time by performing pujas and socializing within the community. The men gather every few days to enjoy a few drinks and play cards and other traditional games like sholo. The women are more lively when they get together. They gossip and sing while still knitting their sweaters and socks. Although there are only 10 households in the village, Todnam has a variety of interesting people pursuing various trades. Farming is the main profession here, but we also have people like the retired Lama next door who teaches Buddhist scripts to the youngsters in the village. Nawang, my friend and landlord, is part of a Bush and Lama troop. There is Tashi the tailor, Sering the taxi driver, Nurbu the contractor, Karma the mason, and so on. It is interesting to see how a little village like Todnam has such various people practicing different trades in order to be self-sufficient as a community. It is impressive how the people of Pin Valley have managed to hold on to their traditions in these changing times. Festivals like Dachang in winter and Sunchok in autumn are celebrated close to their original forms and with great enthusiasm. The men from Pin Valley can all read the Tibetan script and are in high demand during the winter months for reading the scriptures in religious ceremonies around Spiti and Kinnor. The mystical Bush and Lama tradition is still alive in Pin Valley, despite having practically disappeared from Tibet. Pin Valley is the last bastion of these unique traditions before they disappear forever. My first visit to Todnam was limited to just 1 week, but it was enough to motivate me to come back for more and experience life in this unique little village. I was touched by the warmth and kindness of its people and was inspired by their day-to-day struggles in order to survive in this stunningly beautiful but impossibly harsh part of our country. So I returned to Todnam multiple times over the course of the next 2 years, capturing little snippets of life across various seasons in this wonderful village. This series is the culmination of my 2 years of work, 2 years in the story of Todnam, the little village with a big heart.